Welcome to Dr. Ask 24 News YouTube channel.
Darwin, I am going to host a topic on the basis global management theories. See, now these practices has been done. We are going to talk about the management theories or management concepts which has been evolved so long ago. And for example, I will go with this example. We have come across lot of historical monuments in our earth. For example, you take again a pyramid. Pyramid has been built up with the help of lot of people, like more than lakhs of people have been involved in the building up of a pyramid. See, just imagine 2000 to 3000 years ago, whether people had this type of managerial skills to build up that type of a historical evident buildings. Those times also people had an idea about the management, but it was not being defined, it was not being theoretically given by someone or somebody has authored that this is the definition of management. In 1985, that was been given as a definition of management, and that has been started as a subject. See, always there is a debate between, in management, between whether management is an art or management is a science. See, we have to understand what is this art, what is this science. For the better understanding, we will go by this, like, no, scientific management, you take, for example, X plus Y gives Z. So there should be some evidence which proves that, okay, this according to this process, according to this catalyst, we are going to have this result. So that is how been evidently proved, that we call it as scientific knowledge. Whereas here management deals with the scientific knowledge also. For example, if you take the production area, we come across. And next one is art. Art does not deals with any sort of scientific reasons, but for example, you take the behavioral theory, where it talks about the feelings, emotions of the people. So that is how. Now this management is involved of both, neither it is an art, neither it is an science, whereas it is combination of both. It has been it has been imbibed together. So now we will go with the topics called about the management science, theory, practices, and management, society, external environment. This we will learn accordingly. See, before going to the management, we should have an understanding about the theories which we have been come across about the evolution of management. First and foremost, they have come across with this idea behind the management is, when they introduce, they have come across with the classical theory, neoclassical theory, scientific theory, again behavioral theory, and there are a lot of things which has come across, and the evolution process goes on, and now we have come across with the contingency theories also. So that is the level of evolution we have come across in that, and currently which we are practicing now, that is what we are going to discuss today. See, now management, for a simplest understanding for any learner, you just think, management is something, a manager, a person who manages the certain things, maybe resources or the manpower or the money or any other certain things which can be managed, and they have a common objective. For example, a businessman, you forget about a big conglomerate or a big industrialist, you take one small entrepreneur who is doing some value addition to the product, and he is selling his product. You imagine how he procures the material, he makes he gives some value addition to the product by the help of the manpower and the finance which he allocates, again he goes and sells with a profit. All this put together we call it as managing skills, and if there is any interruption during this process, he could able to manage that interruptions, and he could come across with the his personal benefits. So that's how it goes. Now objective of the now you take this example in your mind and go through these ideas, you will have an understanding about this objectives of the management. The following objective can be achieved after studying this unit. So that is how the process goes. We'll see, it will be helping out to understand. This whole syllabus will be helping you to understand about the global management theory and social responsibility of professional engineers. See, there are engineering ethics. There is a paper called Engineering Ethics which talks about the ethical engineering and all, and recognize, this is the introduction area for all those subjects, and recognize of professional engineering ethics, again comprehend the international management necessities. So we talk about the IBM, that is international business management, import export and so on. So that is all the introduction goes with. Now by the end, try to learn these things. I will see by one by one. See, learn the management and objectives, importance, nature of management, functions of management, and who managers are, what are the capacities of the manager, one, what he has to learn or in what way he has to behave, all those things. Last one is roles and managerial skills of manager. We will see that. And this is how it goes. Introduction to management, need management. See, the first point which talks about is all sizes, sizes of the organization, small or large. The point says like this. See, whether it may be a very small concern or it may be a very big concern. You take any MNC company who is having more than 30,000, 50,000 employees, or there are, for example, if you take the public sector, railway industry, it has more than lakhs and lakhs of employees who is, and they also practices same sort of management. You take any small scale industries, like who has a very 6-7 employees who is working in the organization, the company law says like that. 1956, the company law says that the people of, around a group of people, like 10 or more people joined together to work on a common objective, that is called as company. Now, you just take, imagine like this, just 10 number of people or the lakhs and lakhs of employees who involve in the same sort of things, they both follow the similar type of managerial. Maybe, it may be in wider portion, they may be having lot of intermediaries of managerial activities, but the whole scenario is same. Anyhow, they will have something called objective or goal, and the whole employee will be working on that particular goal oriented things. So that is very common. Next one is like all types of organizations. Here we need to understand what is the profit and non-profit organizations. Profit organization, everybody knows. See, you can always see these things in your day-to-day life. For example, if you see recently they have introduced, today they have been talking in the news, like top 10 richest man in the India, like Anil Ambani. As usual, Anil Ambani comes in the number one in the list of Forbes. The list was taken by the Forbes, and in this list you cannot see Tata at all. He is a very big conglomerate. It is not industrialist, he is conglomerate. It is a group of industries. They have more than 100 plus number of industries, types of industries. They never come under this organizations at all, or the companies at all, or this type of Forbes list at all. The reason behind it is the 60% of the 60% of the income or the revenue which they generate, that does not involve with any profit making. They give it in the trust, Tata Trust name. Okay. Whereas the profit, like for example, you take the our own real Ambani, whereas Reliance Industry, they have a CEO or somebody who makes the profit sort of things, and they do involve. So profit, non-profit, profit normal organization, anyone who can make the profit out of their business. Non-profit is something like, you take a charitable trust, or you take any trust. So these people will involve into the things, and there are other industries also. You can take, for example, you cannot see union in the police departments. So these are sort of non-profitable things, whereas they, and next one is organization in all levels, like all organization have the bottom, top, everything. See, normally you will learn in the upcoming topics, whereas the management can be divided into three different levels. First one is top level, middle level, and tertiary level or bottom level. And organization areas of manufacturing, marketing, human resources, and accounting and information systems. See, when you talk about the management, these all things come. You take any nominal organization, this will, you will come across with all these areas. See, industry may be having first is HR market, HR department. Next one is finance department. Next one you will come across with the production department, then R&D, that is research and development, and next one is marketing, accountancy, and information technology, all those things. This all are the combination of an industry. You cannot say that this industry can run without this and all. Anyhow, if there is a very less number of employees, they will be taking the responsibility. For example, in a small company, the accountancy and HR work will be done by a same person. So that may happen. You cannot say that this process is not happening. So that's how the management goes. Is you all have to remember is the companies, whether it is small or large, or it is whether profit or non-profit organization, or whether it is a top level management or a low level management or a bottom level management, all this involves, and departments, several organizational departments which involves. The next one we will go ahead with, the who are managers. See, try to have this understanding. So how does your mom manages things at home? I am very fond of telling this example, because that is how you see live example with your own parenting. For example, your mother may be preparing something. For example, some guest has arrived and she may be having only the milk and she may not have sugar. Okay. Immediately she will make up another arrangement, like we can go with the jaggery sort of things. And when the guest comes, she cannot say that I don't have sugar and I am going to add jaggery and all. So they will come with some other recipe and they will put and they will give you and serve. See, this was a good special recipe we have prepared for you. So that that is how the managing level. Okay, for example, she may be preparing any other recipe or food, and that time she does not have chili, she will be managing with the cardamom. So she is the best example for managing things at our home. See, even in 1994, somebody has interviewed Dr. Manmohan Singh, and he, in his interview, he has said that how do you manage to go for budgeting sort of things. The good answer given by Dr. Manmohan Singh was this, like, I used to observe my home, and what is the budgeting allocation done by my family, that is what implies to my country also. See, you just see the level of managemental activities which we observe from home to bigger industries, and country, running country is not a joke, right? So that's how it goes. And manager, so your mom is a very good manager now, and manager, someone who coordinates and oversees the work of other people so that the organizational goals can be accomplished. See, organizational goals, see, when you see any company, they will be having something to serve to the public. They may be in demand of that particular product or goods, and that has been served to the public, and that will be the common objective. You take any company, for example, any fooding beverage companies. The beverage companies, they are providing the soft drinks to the people, and there will be some demand, and whereas they will be trying to supply with the good flavor sort of things, and they are obviously marketing it, and they create a demand and they try to give that. So in that way, when the manager comes into the picture, he will have a common objective, and that common objective will be given this, he will be acting as a disseminator and a passing the information to all level of the people, all level of the employees, and that will be accomplished together. That's how the manager comes, someone who coordinates with the public, people, money, and resources, or transport, anything which who can coordinate with all, oversees the work of other people. Whether, for example, today's production, we are expecting like 100 units of product should be produced. That will be overseen. There may be changes in the number of units production. For example, it may be less or it may be more. If it is more, nobody is going to bother. But if it is less, there is a very important thing we have to look into it, that, and we have to resolve the problem. And we should make sure that the number of units of product should be manufactured in that particular day. That is how the company runs. They cannot have the fluctuation in their production at all, right? Other people, organization goals can be accomplished. So if you like my videos, subscribe my channel and share with your friends, and also getting more videos from my channel, to press bell button.